Good morning. Hey, it's Dr. James. I hope you're off to a beautiful start today. It's so wonderful, and I'm deeply grateful to see you this morning. Thank you for your time, and thank you for your energy. And this morning, I want to talk to you about death. And I'm on my way to a funeral right now to celebrate the life of an amazing human being who deeply touched my heart, literally has touched thousands of people's hearts. And I, over the last 30 plus years, have had the opportunity, the blessing, the honor, the privilege of being with people who are winding down their life, getting their world in order before they go. And there are so many things I have learned by being with people who have done their work most all of their life. So when it comes time to say goodbye, there's no work to do. And I want you to, wow. And I've also been with people who had so much work still to do. The kind of work that we all know, that's the hard work, right? Forgiving people, saying the things to people that we've held inside because we either didn't feel worthy or we didn't feel we could give them that, or we just felt like holding back on the truth was gonna be easier than speaking the truth. So I wanna share with you a few things I have learned about being a part of people's last days as a clinician, doctor, friend, family member. And these are the three things I want you to know. The people who have the blessing of knowing that they are on their way out, they have had a blessing of living a life that has been awake. They know that every single moment of every single day and every single human being they're in contact with, they get a chance to leave a legacy. And they don't leave those legacy moments like we're having right now. And you're going to go from this video and you're going to see a human being that you love. You're going to see yourself and hopefully have a deep love for you. And you will talk to yourself or you will talk to this person. Talk to this person in a way that you may never see them again. And I know that sounds a little morbid, maybe a little dramatic, but you don't know. Because I've also lost people, and I'm sure you have too. You've lost them like that. And there were so many things that were not said. So do yourself an amazing day today. Express everything. Hug them long and strong and look them in the eye. And if for goodness sakes they are with you, hide your phone and get right here. And if you love them, tell them so. If there's something that you are so deeply and appreciative of, something you know about them, make sure they know it. And if they have something beautiful to say to you, receive it. Receive it. The second thing, and this is a hard one, the people who I have been with who have left the planet peacefully, they have learned the art of forgiveness. They have done the kind of work that they look at their lives and they say, you know what? I have been to forgive myself for the things that I wished I had done, wished I had said. And once and for all, I'm going to say, you know, I'm clearing the slate and saying, I am a human being living in this experiment called life, in this earth suit. And it's a temporary situation. So there are times when fear got in the way. There are times when darkness kind of kept me from seeing the ability to lay the loving light on someone, including myself. And I'm going to forgive myself. And I'm going to be heroic in that forgiveness. I'm going to be the first to forgive. In fact, that is the root of forgiveness. First to give is forgiveness. First to give the love. First to give the hall pass. First to give the honor. First to give the blessing. First to give the love. That is forgiveness. And the third thing I've learned, and I learned this last week, my wife and I and the family were sitting with this beautiful soul as she was winding down her life, and we had a chance to help her choose the music that she wanted to have play at her celebration of life. And she said something that was so beautiful. She said, the last thing I want to have people do is feel sad. I don't want to have sad music. My life has been grand. My life has been a celebration all the time. And I want music that celebrates life. And as I looked at her in her last days, she was sitting in her wheelchair. She's weak, but her eyes were bright and clear. And I said to her, thank God. I thank God for giving me the privilege and loving me so much that you let me love you and you let me know you, because you have taught me so much about life. and you've taught me so much about grace and gratitude. So that's something we should all strive for. Let the people who you leave behind say thank you and make them feel, help them to feel that God loved them so much that they got a chance to love and know you. Thank you. I love you. Let's live out loud and let's live like our life depends on it and love that loudly. Bye for now.